And again, when he bringeth in the history of the world, he saith, and let all angels of God worship him. And the angels, he saith, who maketh the angels do, and he misseth a flame of fire. Blessed unto the Son, he saith, I throw, O God, his forever and ever, and set your praises, in the scripture, Elohim, thou hast loved righteousness and hate iniquity. Therefore, God, even thy God, hath known to do with the oil of gladness and love thy pillows. And thou, Lord, in the living, thou hast laid the foundation of the earth, and the heaven, thou the works of thy hands. They shall perish without the maidens, and they shall wax old as thou the garments. And his vesture shalt thou fold them up, and they shall be changed. For thou hast the same, and thy ears shall not fail. But to which of the angels said he at any time, sit my right hand, and so I make by no means my footstool? Are they not all ministering spirits, sent forth to minister for them, who shall be the heirs of salvation, their due? Therefore we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest any time we should let them slip. For if the Lord spoke, my angels will steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience receive a just recompense or reward. How shall we escape? If we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord, was confirmed all unto us by them that heard him, God also bearing witness of signs and wonders and divers miracles, and gifts of the Holy Ghost according to his own will? For as angels we have not put in submission, the world become, where we speak, and one in a certain place specified, saying, Who is man that thou art mindful of him, or a son of man that thou visitest him? How madest him, how low in angels thou fattest him, the glory and honor, and didst set him over the works of thy hands? Thou hast put all things in submission under his feet, for in that he put all in submission under him, he let nothing that is not put under him. But now we see not yet all things put under him, but we see Jesus, whose veil is below, and the angels of suffering of death, and the glory and honor that he may be raised above, to taste death of every man. For it became him for whom are all things, and by whom all are things, and bringing many sons unto glory, to make the captain of salvation perfect through sufferings. For both he that sanctified and they are sanctified are all of one, for which cause he is not ashamed to call them brethren, saying, I will bear thy name upon the earth of my brethren, and in the midst of the church will I sing praise unto thee. And again I will put my trust in him, and again the whole high children which God hath given me. For as much as then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, the old son himself likewise took part of the same, that through death he might destroy him that had the power of death, and is the devil, and deliver them who fear through fear of death, for all through their lifetime subject to bondage. For verily he took not on him the nature of angels, but he took on him the seed of Abraham. Wherefore, in all things that behoved him to be made like unto his brethren, that he might be merciful and faithful high priest and things pertaining to God, to make reconciliation for the sins of the people. For him that he himself hath suffered being tempted, he is able to secure them that are tempted. Therefore, wherefore, holy brethren, partakers of the heavenly home, consider the apostle high priest of our profession, Christ Jesus, who was faithful to him and appointed him all, as also Moses was faithful in all his house. For this man was counted worthy of more than Moses, inasmuch as he who hath built the house hath more honor than the house. For every house is built for some man, but he that built all things is God. And Moses really was faithful, and all his house as a servant, by testimony of those things which were to be spoken after the Christ, as a son out of his own house, whose house we are we, if we hold fast the confidence and rejoicing but hold firm unto the end. Wherefore, as the Holy Ghost said, today if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in provocation, for they have temptation of the Lord answer when your fathers sent to me privately, and some I worked 40 years, the fathers grieved for the generation, and said they do always there in their heart, and they have not known my ways, so which were my wrath, they shall not enter into my rest. Say, keep brethren, lest there be any of you, and you will harden not believe, departing from the living God, but exhort one another daily. Father, it is full today, lest any of you be hardened through the discipleness of sin, for if we are made partakers of Christ, if we hold the beginning of our conscience, stick fast unto the end. Father, it is said, today you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, for some, when they had heard it, did provoke obvious not all that came out of Egypt by Moses. But with whom was he grieved 40 years? Was it not with them that had sinned, whose heart it is thou, and the Lord, to whom swore he that they should not enter into rest, but to them that believed not, so we see that they could not enter in because of unbelief? So therefore, let us therefore fear, lest the promise may be left to us, of entering into his rest, and if you should seem to come short of it, for on us was the gospel preached as well as in them, thus the word preached did not profit them, and being mixed with it in them, for part we heard it. For we which have believed and do unto the rest, as he said, as I have sworn in my wrath, and they shall enter into my rest, although the works were finished from the foundations of the world.